Most of my dreams seem to come true, and I'm so thankful that they do. I have lots of dreams, and they usually come true, and I'm so glad. Many people are wondering, why would I put my private home movies on television? Well, I thought it was time to do so because many people have opinions about me. And they haven't even met me. They don't even know me. So I thought it was time to open up, to show them who I really am. I'm just simply Michael Jackson.
This is the Michael Jackson the world knows. The legendary superstar who has been at the forefront of the music industry for virtually his entire life. One of the most electrifying performers the world has ever seen. He's raised hundreds of millions of dollars for charity and sold more than 200 million albums. But who is Michael Jackson when he's not in the spotlight? You'll find out in the next 2 hours as you are allowed an unprecedented look into the personal life of one of the world's greatest entertainers. You'll see Michael at home with his children and traveling with his most intimate friends. You'll be allowed inside the gates of Neverland for a reunion with the Jackson family and share personal, never-before-seen moments between Michael and some of the world's biggest celebrities. Eddie Murphy, Elizabeth Taylor, Michael Jordan, Macaulay Culkin, Chris Tucker, and Princess Diana. All tonight on Michael Jackson's Private Home Movies. The King of Pop, up close and personal.
As far back as I can remember, I've been in front of the camera. Not just the TV cameras, but I'm talking about my family taking home movies of me when I was really, really little. We lived in Gary, Indiana. My father worked in a steel mill, and we lived on a street called Jackson Street. Coincidentally, that was the name of the street. And imagine, 9 kids living in a 2-bedroom house. We had to wait in line to take baths, and that's a snowball fight, I think. Wrestling in the snow, that's me on the far right. I don't want nothing to do with it. They were pretty rough. Yeah, that's me, I'm freezing. I think that's Tito on the ground. This is the living room. We would move out all the furniture, and I remember, and we would dance and perform. And we loved it. You can see the smile on my face that I loved it. And my father was standing right in front of us, watching us, making sure we did everything just right. That little girl that my mother is holding is Janet, who is now Mrs. Rhythm Nation. And that's a party. We played a lot of parties. We're actually performing the music that they're dancing to. That's the guitars. You look in the back, you see me spinning around right there. And my mother made all of our costumes. We did parties, we opened shopping centers, we did any kind of thing, you know. But we traveled constantly every night. The record company usually liked for you to support your album and go on tour. And I don't like to. I do like relating to the fans, giving the fans a chance to see you face to face, because you go from Hong Kong to Africa to China to Brazil to, you know, Singapore, Switzerland, London, Paris, Russia, and the stadiums are just jammed, and it's the energy is great. It's fantastic. And we have, I don't know how they enjoy the show, because it's festival seating. They don't want chairs. Even if there were chairs, they would stand on them and just, so we have a tent on the side with, it's usually like 5,000 faints every night. And we have all these doctors and paramedics, but it's a difficult thing to tour. You go from one continent to another, you're sleepy, the time zones are different. You can't sleep after the show. Adrenaline is up here.
know.
Well, can we just do it again without the negative saying that you don't like the tour? Just
I don't like it though.
I know, but
I go through hell. I go through hell touring.
Okay, then touring is
that I'll make it positive then.
Yeah, just don't.
For you know the truth.
Yeah.
Okay.
And action, Michael.
I love to tour. You guys must
just say.
Why are you all start laughing? I'm going to get into it. No, but seriously, there is a good part of touring. It's the fans. I love my fans. You go to any city, anywhere in the world. They know all the songs, all the dance moves, everything. They even come with the tape on their fingers, the hats and the gloves and everything. It's just a wonderful experience. I love it. The fans are the reason why I do the tours. And it's very important to give the best show that we can possibly give them.
As far as cautiousness and being alert and musicianship, you guys are wonderful.
Thank
you. I would say the same for wardrobe and technology. They made a couple of mistakes yesterday. You were great, which wasn't your fault, I have to say. Okay.
All right, thank you very much. All right, we're going to get out of here. Okay.
It's a spiritual thing also, because when certain songs we play, like Heal the World, We Are the World, or Man in the Mirror, the whole stadium is lit up with these big lighters they use, and they know when to do it. You hit one chord and they know exactly what it is. It's very emotional. I mean, it's fun, and I love to entertain. That's one of my favorite things. I think the fans see that. Actually, I know they see it, because when I walk out on stage, they give me so much love, and that's everywhere I go, every time I walk on stage. One of the best moments is right here. It's right in the middle of the show, and it's my birthday, and I'm thousands of miles away from my family. When they surprised me with a full marching band, and then they brought out this huge, beautiful birthday cake.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Michael.
I realized that I've got family all over the world, everywhere I go, because my fans really show me the love, and I love them just as much. I've met a lot of people in my life, and very few are real, real, real friends. You can probably count them on one hand. And Elizabeth is one of the most loyal, loving, caring people that I know. She decided to transform Neverland into its first Christmas, because I don't celebrate Christmas.
It is 1993, and this will be Michael Jackson's very first Christmas. It has taken me, I would think, about 5 years of talking him into celebrating Christmas at Netherlands, because I understood that if you are a Jehovah's Witness, you don't celebrate Christmas. When he quit being a Jehovah's Witness, I said to Michael, I think Christmas is a wonderful way of celebrating love. It's a celebration of love. And I can't see Christmas without Michael, or Michael without Christmas.
It's pretty, isn't it?
I had no idea she was planning this. This is a real surprise.
Michael?
That's my bedroom that she's coming to now.
Michael, it's the spirit of Christmas.
come to haunt you.
I'm not easy to wake up.
Michael!
Don't jump at the side of my little dog.
She know I don't like that dog because I'm afraid of dogs. They're little, but they bite.
Oh, you son of a bitch. Come on. Welcome to your first Christmas.
Oh my God. It's incredible. I can't believe this. This is the first time.
She decorated the entire house.
That's yours.
Santa King?
Santa from Bel Air.
Santa from Bel Air. The opening?
Sure.
At the same time, it's exciting. I felt guilty, too, at the same time. I remember going in the bathroom crying later. Because I felt I had done something wrong. Because I was raised not to ever celebrate it.
Ooh, love it.
I do have one.
Yes, putting it on right now.
You realizing you're photographing me without any makeup on?
Love it. Super soaker. Now I know how to wake up Elizabeth tomorrow.
How? The awful villain. Oh my God!
You better lock your door.
A shooting gallery.
This shit is a super soaker. I can feel it and tell.
And it says,
Ouch.
I want a squirt gun. I want a squirt machine gun.
She's snatching presents. And I have this one. It's for you, but can I have it?
Yes.
Thank you.
What is it?
It's a water gun. Water gun.
How do you know it's a water gun?
Because I see it at the top.
That's not fair.
It's a super
Make it.
Soaker.
Make it.
Thank you. You're too kind.
Plastic suit.
If you're wondering why I love Super Soaker so much, it's because if you come to Neverland, it's a rule that you are bound to get wet. Either be thrown in the pool, or you have a water balloon fight, or a Super Soaker fight. And I love all of the above. That's Janet. We think so much alike.
I love this.
He judges you so bad.
And here come Macaulay Culkin.
You ready?
Come on, Daddy.
Come on, Daddy.
See, Mac takes big buckets of water and throw them on. He cheats a lot. But he's fun. He loves to have fun, just like me. We're off to the field. Super Soakers are really high tech. They got some really great ones now. That's Mac's older brother, Shane. Okay, this is, we're preparing the water balloon fight.
What's the name of our group this time?
What do you feel,
Nicole? I think so. What were we last time? That was okay.
We had teams. We used the whole ranch. My favorite thing in the world to play, if you call it a sport, it's a sport. It's a water balloon fight. Because I like the way they splatter when they hit. I've never lost a water balloon fight. I'm the Michael Jordan of water balloon fighting.
Legions of Doom.
Yay.
We won the fight again and again.
But Janice, what's it like on the winning team?
If he's gonna get me.
Great.
This is the face of a person who would do something like that. I'm gonna be innocent. Right?
I mean, I went through this entire water balloon fight.
Victory!
completely dry. But knowing Macaulay Culkin, he made sure. He schemed on me. He told me to go up on the diving board, and I went up there like a nut. With Thriller, my mission was to make a short film, a story. So it was like watching a mini movie.
It's only a movie.
It's not funny.
You were scared, weren't you?
It wasn't just a video, just a lot of abstract, you know, craziness that doesn't make sense.
Let me tell you. Yes, Michael? I'm not like other guys. Of course not. That's why I love you.
No, I mean I'm different.
What are you talking about?
This is a rehearsal for these scenes. Practicing my acting.
I'm not like other guys. I mean I'm different.
That's for sure.
I'm a monster.
Uh-huh.
When the moon is full, I metamorphosize into another being. I'm a monster.
Shut away!
And one other thing I have to get straight. People always tend to be rude to me. And I'm just not taking it no more. Rob, how close are you?
I don't know. Pretty close.
Like this? Or can you see chess?
I can see right about where your Nike is.
What a schmuck. Back up. Ah, dipwit. Like this. That's how you back up, okay?
This is me experimenting with socks for Thriller. Glow socks, light socks, rhinestone socks. I tried everything. I didn't want to copy people. I wanted to be an innovator, a pioneer.
Okay, let's go. Action.
I just cracked that thing over John Landis' head. I love John Landis. He's great to work with.
To go.
Great man. He always turns me upside down.
Let me know when you need Jackson.
I was wondering.
Oh, this is on the way to the Grammys. I had gotten a record 13 nominations for Thriller. And so I didn't know what was gonna happen, really. That's Emmanuel Lewis, one of my best friends.
What's your character, Emmanuel?
That's Gladys Knight, the person I just hugged. Her and Diana Ross are responsible for launching the Jackson 5. And we got a contract with Motown, and it started from there. Oh, there's my man, the real creator of rock and roll, Chuck Berry.
Like all times, remember?
I love you, man. I'm glad you looked
Thanks
up.
That's one of the greatest entertainers that ever lived, James Brown. I idolized him. I think we're on our way going inside the building.
He's rapping.
Emmanuel. He tries to go up under her dress. He's a flirt. See, I liked her and he liked her too, so there's competition.
Welcome to the 26th Annual Grammy Awards.
It's me walking in. When we walked in, we got a huge, it's like a tumultuous applause. People really was excited. This is after I had won the Grammys. It was a world's record. I had won, I won 8. And Thriller still to this day stays the largest selling album worldwide. So I can't even catch up with it with my own albums. It's 60 something million now. Michael. I was very happy and I thank God because it was my dream and it had come true.
Michael!
I said on one of my interviews, it's my dream to go in a supermarket and just shop and be like everybody else and put things in a basket because I can't do it. Because when I try to do it, people crowd around you. They want autographs and they want you to sign things and take pictures. That's why I love disguises so much. I could sit on a bench at Disneyland and see what people really do and talk about. But when they see it's Michael Jackson, they change. I don't see the real thing. You know, it's so I want to see the real world, what it's really like, and it's very difficult. So a good friend of mine, who owns this mall. He had them close the whole shopping mall, and he had people in there that I knew pretending as if they were shopping, so it felt like, you know, it was a real environment. Had my cousins dressed like they were bag boys, and I went shopping. It was great. They planned everything right down to the music.
Yeah, now people know who you are when you start to put the glove on.
Where's he going?
Big red.
It was a lot of fun. It gave me a chance to see, in my way, kind of what the real world is like, even though it wasn't the real thing. Eventually, I started recognizing people, like the woman in the blonde wig is my nanny. Even Elizabeth Taylor was there. She was on the cover of this magazine.
Gotcha. What are you looking at?
Where's your card?
It is. Oh, that one right there.
Everybody was messing with me, trying to steal my card.
It's Wilda. Is there a problem here?
Where's my card?
Wait. I don't trade cards with you.
What's up here? Where did my card go?
Right there, just take
Sorry,
that one.
Was he trying to steal your card? 100%.
If you can't keep track of your card, you shouldn't shop.
Yeah. Yeah, please. He's like, I gotta buy that.
Michael Bay.
Oh, no!
Why me?
My first shopping experience in 30 years.
Just remember,
Michael Jackson ice cream.
It was just like being at Disneyland, in my opinion, because I got to do something that I usually don't get to do. Shannon and my mother backstage at one of my concerts. They're singing almost as loud as me. But I remember one thing my mother said to me. We were in Copenhagen, I think, and there was just a sea of people. There was like over 200,000 people. And her eyes were watery. She was on the side of the stage. And I said, Mother, what's wrong? Why are you crying? She said, when you were a baby and I was holding you in my arms, I would have never dreamt it. You would do this. You would have this kind of effect on an audience like this. And I gave her a hug and tried to get her on stage. She's so shy. She, no matter what, she will not come on stage. But I thought that was really sweet of her. Well, Bette, we did this in the subway of New York, and Martin Scorsese was the director. That's just that rehearsal at the Hemsley Palace, choreographing it.
We're forgetting the fact that we're gonna go bop, 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 bop. We're gonna hold that away.
We had 2 days to choreograph. Yeah, I love that pressure.
It's gonna be more tense. They say the sky's the limit. And to me, this will be true. I'm a friend, you have seen nothing. There's a way to get
because I'm bad. I'm bad. It's mostly just spontaneous movement, which it should be. Because to have everything choreographed would be kind of hokey for this type of song. And this was Wesley Snipes' first acting part, so I've cast him in this piece.
So that's the way it goes down, eh?
The word on our set that was totally taboo was video. I wouldn't allow it because I didn't like videos. It was so abstract, it made no sense at all. So if you watch pieces that we were doing that I innovated, you know, you could follow a story. So there's an outcome. And to be entertaining as well, that's what we did.
Michael Jackson, he's the king of pop. He helped poor people. He loves small children. I love him because he's very good to small children. He dances good as all people. He every day helps poor people and heal the world. I love him as big as the ocean.
Neverland appeals to the child inside of every man, woman, and child. It's a place where I feel that you can return to your childhood. You find grown-ups, you know, doing things they hadn't done since they were like 10 years old. And it's just a fun, wonderful place to be. It's so much to do. I always wanted to have a place where you're just busy all day and there's just unlimited space to go on quads and mountains and horseback and all kind of fun things. So it's just a fun place. I love it. And I will always love it. And I will never, ever sell Neverland. Neverland is me, you know. It represents the totality of who I am. It really does. I love Neverland.
Okay, here we go on three. Wait, don't cheat.
Ready?
No, but your hands gotta be inside the pocket, man.
No.
I'm gonna beat you.
Ready?
Are you ready?
Wait, no, I'm not ready. Ready? No!
I'm crazy for doing this. Okay, no, you gotta stretch it. Mac, you gotta...
Whoa. I'm not doing the Superman. Ready? Let's go.
You cheater! Whoa!
He cheats a lot. But he's fun. He loves to have fun.
And it took a lot of body coordination and a lot of confidence and courage and belief.
That's my cousin Elijah. Just pushed me in the pool. That's Levon, my other cousin. In the red.
No!
I dried off, they pushed me right back in. I can't believe that. First shot of me with no shirt on.
I'm a nice person! I just took a shower and I washed my hair finally!
See what they do to me? Mac is the most reckless driver. Oh my God.
You almost killed him.
It's his brother Kieran on the back.
Did you see that leaf? Your foot is ran over.
They're good kids, though.
I didn't know you had that leg.
This is what he did. Look, he had the camera and he went.
This is me and my cousin on the trampoline.
That was close to me. This is egg hunt day.
Yeah.
And we're going, how many eggs are there?
45.
How many?
45.
45?
Yeah.
We're looking for 45 eggs.
And there'll be special prizes.
Do we get prizes?
Yeah.
Well, a trip to Bermuda.
Yeah.
And
the
a trip.
The ones with the
speakers. Can we
stop? A trip
now,
to
let's stop now. Let's
ready?
Stop now.
One, two, three, go.
Awesome.
Whoever finds the golden egg gets the biggest prize.
Yes. Hello. I have no fortune. Nothing. Please, you know where they gave me? Would you tell me, please? I want to win this game.
Hey!
Yes! My first egg. My first?
My sixth egg.
Oh my
Which
God.
Which is my seventh egg. Thank
See,
you.
See, there are egg clubs around here.
Hey!
Hi, guys. They steal my egg, please.
The host of the moose.
Michael?
Yeah? He went to lift the thing and I grabbed
him. Hey, Apple here. Say, Apple here.
Oh, it said Apple here.
Most kids never call me by a name Michael, either Applehead or another name, which I don't want to say. It's not a bad word.
In someone's pocket, there's an egg.
Yeah, because I heard what Lee said.
Ah!
10.
And
we had to find 14.
Now, here's our winner. 14 eggs.
We had
$70.
What? Why do you like this? Say, Brad, you have to. Bump down, bump down.
Oh! Why did I let him do that? I was born in here.
There's Gregory Peck and his wife Veronique. See Gregory dancing? That's the child that comes out inside of the men when they come to Neverland. He's one of the nicest people in the world. I really love Gregory Peck and his wife. That's their dog, Blanket, believe it or not. And Blanket's sister is Elizabeth Taylor's dog. Gregory Peck is a dear, dear friend of ours. He's singing, he's happy. Now he would never go on the zipper. I hold the world record on that ride. I went on that for 35 minutes straight.
I like to have those at the house. You want them one or two?
So Michael comes.
Never
again. All right.
I loved it, but I hated it.
When you were going all over.
But Gregory, I mean, he gets on this thing and it brings back his childhood.
Thanks. Can we do it every weekend?
For the short film Jam, I got to work with the greatest sports legend of all time, Michael Jordan.
Michael, how you doing?
Thanks for making it.
I knew this was going to be amazing, so I had all these cameras set up all around us, and there was tons of footage that never made it into the piece. And you're about to see some of the best and some of the worst.
I'm hiring for my team. I need you in the playoffs. I need a point guard.
What's the point guard?
That's the guy who runs all the plays and passes the ball. All you got to do is pass it to me.
We had to play one-on-one. It was so embarrassing. He never missed. But that was the object, for him to teach me to play basketball and for me to teach him to dance, you know?
Can you imagine me trying to dance?
Around me, right here. Backboard.
He's one of the nicest people you can meet. He really is. He spends his summers teaching kids to play basketball. He signs all these autographs.
Now that's consistent.
We had a real game. People crowd around and they watch me playing one-on-one and wondering who's gonna win this game. I wonder who. Look at this, this is cheating like crazy. He takes it and goes up, slams it.
Now, we gotta show me how to moon.
Actually, this is my favorite part of the whole short film because it's candid, you know, it's fun. He was really embarrassed, he said.
Toes in and out.
I'm full of muscle here.
I really wanted to just move his legs in the right place. His feet are like boats.
Put all your energy into your feet. Boom! Just throw it out. Fire. Bow. Throw it. Same system, but you're going back.
But at the same time, okay.
Yeah, because you're taking your weight and you're pushing it back. That's what creates the illusion. It's the weight shifting. Now, as this foot comes back, the other one goes up and...
I think I got it.
Yeah, you can.
Yeah, all right.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah, you got it. Yeah, I got it. Ain't too hard for me to jam. It ain't too hard for me to jam.
It is.
Yeah. It ain't too hard for me to jam.
Ho.
It ain't too hard for me to jam.
Ho. You got it.
Yeah, I think it ain't too hard for me to jam.
Yeah.
It ain't too hard for me to jam.
Ho. You got it.
Wait, what's the point?
Michael, I love you.
He's my only God. I love him. He's perfect.
He's the best.
He's the best.
Joe Jackson Day represents a day for our father. We don't celebrate birthdays, really. So we create a day for our father and a day for our mother. All the family comes and we present them with speeches, how we feel about them, and we give them presents. There he is, the guy who taught me everything on stage. There's Janet. There's Alex, the chimp. She's got earrings on. See, my father loves animals. I think that's where I got my love for animals from. But this was his day. There's two names for that ride, the spider or the puke bucket. I don't think Janet got on this. She's just a little chicken.
Whoa.
But the real fun is when you see 500 kids, you know, terminally ill children having fun in Neverland. I mean, that's when the park comes to life. They're having fun. Here's my mother and father shooting together, which is a great shot. That's fantastic. She's taking the popcorn. This is my nephew Taj, nephew Augie. Look at her, look at her. She's like me, she loves the camera. That's Janet and myself. Yeah, well, the whole family calls her Dunk, which is short for donkey. We've always called her that since she was a little girl. We're going into the movie theater to see a magic show. Two ice cream, that's her. Janet loves to eat.
This is the one. This is it.
Watch Augie.
Ooh.
They gotta put their neck in there. Look at Augie. He's backing up.
What was it? Do you wanna sit down? Okay.
Okay, we're gonna do it. Here it goes. Everybody's gonna say one.
One.
Everybody's gonna say two.
Two.
Two. Everybody's gonna say.
He ran. Well, look at him. He ran. He ran out of the theater. That's hilarious. Yeah, this is back at the other house.
Let me get out.
That day Janet and I gave my father, we bought him a boat, and he loves to fish. He loves fishing. He loves the outdoors. He's an outdoorsman.
That's why you all have me so good. It's nice. You got this.
Rightfully mine, dude.
That's nice.
Listen.
You can trail it, too.
Oh, he loves it.
She come on over in this boat. Look at her.
He's teasing her.
Let's go boat, Mom.
Oh, it's a big day. It's very hard to work with Chris Tucker because when the director says action, you just start screaming, laughing.
Come on, man.
So I just look at him. His eyes pop out of his head because he's so funny, and that's what makes it difficult.
Look what I said. You have an ambitious nature and may make a name for yourself. That's me, man.
He does these little things in between where he's just improvising, and it's very funny. Some of the best stuff in Rock My World wasn't shown on the screen.
What's making a face for you?
Perfect, so wet.
So no hug.
No hug, just a kiss. You go the other way. You tilt to your left. You tilt.
I want some real Chinese food. Yeah, some real food that they eat.
In this short film, we ate all this food and we ran out without paying. It's so fun.
Hey, you forgot to pay!
Ah.
You forgot to cook the food!
Forgot to pay today!
Food wasn't no good!
Come on!
Keep it to yourself!
Come on! Come on! Pay today!
You're lucky we ain't suing you!
Got to pay! Got to pay! Got to pay!
Get it.
Knocked it out. Yeah. Rock my world.
I love great talent. People like Chaplin, I mean, God, how could you not admire his genius? He was the king of pathos. I mean, he knew how to touch your heart, and he knew how to make you laugh and cry at the same time. I mean, he was the master of that. And I find some of that in what I do. I relate to him. I sometimes feel like I am him. And I like to dance very much, so sometimes I'll close myself in a room and I'll just put on spotlights and put on my sister's music, Janet's music, and I'll dance and discover new things where I can go with my body. I always tell her my favorite song of hers is Rhythm Nation and The Knowledge, because I love the bass lick. It really just makes me crazy. It makes me wild. And we think so much alike that we come up with the same ideas at the same time sometimes, a lot of times. And I told her at one time that dancing was going toward more military style movement. I had done a short 3D film with Francis Ford Coppola and George Lucas called Captain EO for Disney. We did a lot of military stuff, and Janet had seen it, and she called me on the phone. She said, Michael, is it okay if I steal what you were doing in Captain EO? I go, what do you want to steal? She said, the military stuff. I go, I could choke you. She go, why? I said, because I was going to do, my next short film was going to be all military. I said, but know what? Since you're my sister and I love you, I'll let you do it. You take it. And that's when she did Rhythm Nation.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
That's her best short film, I think. Every time I do an album, I write almost nearly 100 or over 100 songs. So we have to cipher them down. And Smooth Criminal almost did not make it on the album. And on top of that, once it was on the album, I decided that I would make the short film into a Western. I went on the ranch on the property, and I had a cameraman to pretty much shoot me coming up with ideas of how I wanted this thing to be. I know I wanted hats, and I wanted wind, and I wanted just a lot of attitude, you know, a lot of some quick cut, some big shot, long shot. And at the last minute, I said, no, I don't want to do it as a Western. It should be like Hot Summer Night in Chicago, 1945, an underground kind of thing going on. You've been hit by a smooth criminal. I think that was the best way to go. It's one of my favorite pieces. I get more comments from Smooth Criminal than any other pieces I've ever done, really.
You've been hit by
Lady Diana, in real truth, was one of the sweetest people I've ever known, because we could relate to each other. We share something in common with the press. I don't think they hounded anyone more than her and myself. And we had a relationship, a very good relationship, where we would call each other late at night for me, and we would, you know, just talk about, just like crying each other's shoulders, how hard and difficult and how mean the tabloids can be and how they lie and twist stories around. But she came to a concert at Wembley Stadium in London. And, you know, they do when the royal family comes, you have to line up and you meet the family and everything. But at some point, she called me away from the line. And I saw Prince Charles look at me. And I said, oh boy. She said, I want to talk to you. So I said, yeah, what's happening? She said, are you going to do Dirty Diana tonight? I said, no, no, I took it out of the show, out of respect for you. She said, that's my favorite song. I said, are you serious? I said, I took it out of respect because Dirty Diana, you're in the audience. So at that point, I couldn't put it back in the show because it was too close to showtime. So I remember Prince Charles leaving the line, walking over to us, and he said, what are you talking about? And she said, oh, nothing, like that. So that was that story. And there's a couple of other ones, but I don't want to, you know, say too much. She was just a wonderful, warm, compassionate person. Very caring, very caring. It was real. It wasn't publicity stuff. It was real. She really cared. I'm the same way. I feel the same way that she does about children and the future of our children and the future of the world. What I usually do on my off days, I do as many hospitals as I do concerts. I do as many orphanages as I do concerts. But because it's good news, the press don't cover it. They want bad news. But I do it from my heart. I don't do it to wave a flag and say, look at me. We bring bags of toys and posters and albums, and you should see how it transforms these kids. They jump up and down and they're so happy. This is Lisa Marie and myself at a hospital in Budapest. And I saw this little kid. His name was Farkas. He was very sick. He was green in the face, but he had this glow and this sparkle in his eye. I asked this nurse, what's wrong with this kid? She said that he needs a liver. So I said, does that mean he's gonna die? She said, yes, he's gonna die unless he gets a liver. I said, I'm not gonna let him die, this sweet, sweet angel. No matter what it takes, I'm gonna find a liver for him. So I sent my organization around the world. We went all over the place, and it took a long time. And I said, I'm not giving up. I'm not gonna have this child die. I was so happy when I got a phone call. They told me we found the liver, and he has his life. And I'm so proud that I could help him. God bless him. I love you, Farkas. I found a tape that was really exciting because, in truth, I didn't even know it existed anymore. In between the tours, we had a break, and my brothers and I took my mother to Alabama to visit her stepfather.
We're on our way to Alabama.
That's right. Salvation Army tomorrow, Bill. Really, don't laugh. You find good stuff.
Don Quixito. And other places would sell real expensive. I'm telling you, you're going to be hitting them soon with the depressing
I love going to the Salvation Army because I find things that I haven't seen since I was little.
There's Michael over there looking for junk.
They know I like to go through everything. I'm very curious. I go through drawers and go through everybody's closets. I don't steal, but I like to look and explore.
But what they got in there, Mike? Moon Marlin. This is the South, baby.
I love seeing the old colonial homes in the South. I had set this shot of me and my brothers walking down. I have a film camera in my hand.
Fellas, I'm Georgia.
This is my mother in the front, and that lady behind her is my mother's stepfather's mistress.
All right.
I'm Georgia. She's funny. That's me. Look at the shacks. I love this.
He's hiding behind his mom. Hey, Jackson, turn around. What smell like beef jerky?
We were just exploring. They live in those houses. Very interesting. It's a whole different way of life down there.
Y'all tighten up.
We love visiting people we don't know. We try to get these kids to dance, see? So I do a little step and maybe he would join in. He got a little shy. They have these kids have incredible rhythm, but they were shy in front of us.
You keep that thing on me, boy.
He was saying, possums are good eating down here, aren't they?
They ate possum, but I wouldn't have any because I knew it was in the rodent family, and they're very cute. They got these little pink noses and big eyes, and very inviting, but I wouldn't want to eat one.
Papa.
Papa.
Papa, where you been?
That's my mother's stepfather. Papa, Uncle Johnny. I love the way they talk down there.
Where is she? It's
like he's speaking another language, doesn't it?
Sugar Babe, need a hand?
Oh yeah, Sugar Babe. She helps take care of Uncle Johnny. She loves to dance. Sugar Babe. Uncle Johnny is truly a character, and he had this drink called White Lightning. And this drink was so strong, I'm not joking, one sip will get you drunk. It's really strong. My brother Tito took a sip and he went, wow, you couldn't believe it. But I stayed away from it. But Sugar Babe had some, that's why she was dancing.
All right, let's go. Bye, Papa. That's Aunt Georgia they're hugging. She was hiding in the house because she told us when it was time to leave that she couldn't take it, and she's crying. So Bill brought her out.
It was a wonderful experience. It was just really phenomenal. This is behind the scenes on the Black or White short film. And that's John Landis, our director. He's done so many great feature films, Coming to America, American Werewolf in London, The Blues Brothers. He's done three of my short films, and I always have a great time working with John because he's a lot of fun.
I'm gonna let you do one more thinking about my baby. Because if the painting is beautiful, I wanna stay on it longer.
If you're black or
on a global scale, I'd rather hear both sides of the tale.
Macaulay Culkin was also in the Black or White film, too. And John was always goofing off, throwing stuff at us. Here we are scheming to kind of pay John back for all the messing around that he did to us on the set. We had planned this, Mac and I, way before shooting the film, that we would have a big pie fight at the end. We have super soakers, we have stink bombs in the pies, and we waiting for General Landis to show up. Okay. We're practicing how we're gonna do it now.
No. Chin up, Judd.
No. And then you go.
Chin up.
For being so nice to us during the whole thing, we give you this. Turn around. Okay?
Look at him. He's rehearsing.
Okay. We're going to nail John. Now. Okay. Tell me what you're going to say.
I'm going to say, John, in appreciation for working on this great video, we just want to, and then he's going to sneak. I'm just going to keep talking until he sneaks up, and he's going to hit John with the first pie.
Because I'm going to say, John, watch. He's so excited.
I go, John.
Yes, and boom, okay.
Okay,
and then after he gets the first throw, everybody else can start.
Here it is.
This looks very suspicious.
You know something's up, though. He's looking for Mac. Look, he's looking for Mac.
Where's McCall? Where's Mac?
He said, where's Mac?
It's very dangerous to me.
In appreciation for working on the Black or White short film,
We'd
like to say thank you, and we love you, and we think
and
you've
John?
Done
and John?
A wonderful job.
Yeah. John?
Because
what,
every,
Mac?
John?
What, Mac?
That's fantastic. Oh, I love it. It could have gone on and on as far as I care.
We're pranksters, you know. Look at John. Look at John. Look at him, you can't recognize him. One day I get this call from Elizabeth Taylor saying she wants to come to the ranch. She flew out in this helicopter.
How are you?
Hi.
Is Michael out in front?
I knew by the tone of her voice that something was up, but I had no idea how big the surprise was. She came out this huge elephant. Unbelievable.
Great.
At first I was kind of scared because this thing is huge. Eventually I got into it feeding them carrots and stuff like that.
Great.
I love elephants. They're gentle giants, really. Elizabeth was dressed like a gypsy, and that's why we named the elephant Gypsy. It was one of the best presents that I've ever gotten. I was so happy that day. It was a wonderful experience. But what Elizabeth didn't know, that I was planning a surprise for her also.
Oh my God! That's amazing! I love it! Oh, thank you! What's it made of, a carpet?
The gift that I gave Elizabeth to me was very unique. It looks like a painting, but it isn't.
That's incredible!
I love that car.
It's a tapestry. This guy did it piece by piece.
And I wrote something on the bottom.
Oh.
I love you, Michael.
Oh, I love it.
You have a place for it? Maybe.
No, I may have to build a house.
I think it was a shot from one of her movies.
I think it's fabulous.
From that commercial you had, that was beautiful.
Do you like it?
Oh, it's incredible.
Well, maybe you'll see one of my films one of these days.
I knew you were going to. I'm seeing Virginia Woolf this week.
Well, congratulations.
I'm seeing it today.
We have to explain the joke. The last film that Michael saw me in that he thought I was really wonderful in was a film called White Cliffs of Dover. And I was 9 years old. So he's been seeing me as a grown up.
Yeah.
He may never speak to me yet. It's amazing.
It wasn't quite as big as Gypsy, but I think she liked my gift as much as I liked hers.
And what is it you're going to do?
Working with Eddie Murphy is so much fun because he keeps you laughing all day long. He's just naturally talented. The guy is incredible. As funny as Eddie can be, though, there was one moment in Remember the Time that had everyone laughing except Eddie. There was this big hunting bird over his right shoulder as he was sitting on the throne next to Iman. In the middle of the take, the bird decided to take off, and so did Eddie. When he realized that he was the only one who was scared, he thought he had some serious explaining to do.
I'm the, and I don't want y'all to think that I'm running and I'm a punk because Iman didn't move from the bird. But it's two ways to react in a situation like that. You can run or be real still. And she's just being real still. But she's as horrified as I am. See, she was raised in East Africa. She knows if the eagle go crazy, be real still. I'm from Brooklyn, so you run.
When he comes to Neverland, he has a guitar, an acoustic guitar in his hand, and he's screaming reggae songs all through the house. Yeah, just yelling. He's just funny. He'll take any situation and make it funny. I mean, that's his real gift. He's wonderful. I enjoyed working with him a lot. Time off is a rarity in the first place. It's a real rarity. We always end up our tours in fun places like Florida. We stay at the Playboy Club Hotel. These bunnies walking around serving you. You know, they have their little tails on, these little legs and stuff. Fun.
Me and Mac we're in Bermuda and we're looking for some interesting treasure.
Mac and I would go on vacation together, and Mac is very smart, and he's very ingenious in causing trouble.
But it's his idea.
Yeah, so I'm not going to touch him.
And we were in Bermuda together, and we were signing water balloons. He had me signing water balloons, and he was throwing these balloons at the fans on the balcony. They loved it. They wanted more. They were asking for more.
But Mac's throwing it.
So I was signing these balloons, and he kept throwing them.
This balloon is autographed!
I'm signing them, he's throwing them, and that's what we did. Those are snaps, those are little finger things you see there. When you throw them, they pop. And Mac wanted to see if he could light the snaps.
What?
I have to light this thing.
I didn't want him to do it, but
Mac,
he did it anyway.
No, we shouldn't use fire, Mac. I'm scared.
Right in front of the manager.
Especially with the manager standing over you.
Yeah. No, okay, move back.
This is the manager of the hotel, you know. He's gonna run you out.
And he got away with it. The guy said, it's okay, don't worry about it. The footage you see now is Emmanuel Lewis and myself on this speedboat. This is at Disney World, and we had so much fun there. We did everything. We did hot air balloons. We fed turtles. There he is. He's dancing with the characters. He's not shy at all. I was too shy to dance. Oh yeah, I love the water parks. I wish I could do that more often these days, but I'm allergic to the sunlight. I really can't go in the sun. I have to have an umbrella, but then there are times when you just look, it looks like so much fun, you just say, forget it. I'm going. I have to do this. That's F.E.O. Schwartz, we spent the night there. I loved it. It was so much fun. They closed it down. We stayed all night. We opened things. You can rollerblade. They give you pizza. They tell you stories. And nobody wants to go to sleep because you're having so much fun. And this magician here, he's doing this trick. He made me pick a card.
Take it short, everybody, please. Don't let me see.
And I have to show the card to everybody.
Ready? Okay, let me see it.
Then he reveals what the card was.
For the space, yes or no?
No.
No.
And the audience thought it was wrong.
Please concentrate.
But then the real magic started to happen.
Wow.
I love magic.
How about the Yankee space?
Wow.
I want to get that trick.
Incredible.
Look at this damn traffic.
Now, usually I don't do this, but
this is me on vacation with my good friend, Brett Ratner.
That's a good shot. Look at that.
Now, I'm not trying to be rude, but hey, pretty girl, I'm feeling you. The way you do the things you do reminds me of my Lexus coupe.
We're in Miami in rush hour traffic, and we were singing to the music, playing, acting wild, being silly. It's fun. Brett's like a kid, like me. We like to have fun.
It's like murder, she rolled. Once I get you out the clothes, privacy's on the door. Still they can hear you screaming more. Girl, I'm feeling what you're feeling. No more hoping and wishing. I'm about to take my key and stick it in the ignition. So give me that do-do, let me get that beat. Running her hands through my fro, bouncing on 24s. Why they standing up ready? It's the remix to ignition. It's hot and fresh out the kitchen. Mama rolling that body, got it.
You've seen a lot of footage tonight of my life, my joys, my happiness, you know. But what you're gonna see now is what I'm most proud of, what I think life is really all about.
You are the sun. You make me shine. I'm more like the stars that twinkle in the night.
I love and adore my children. They mean everything to me. When they're in public, though, I conceal their faces because I want my children protected. At home, they have a normal life. They play with other kids, and they have a good time. They're laughing a lot. They run around. They even go to school. It's a normal life for them. But in public, I must protect them.
What are you
going to
do when you grow up?
I'm going to be like my daddy.
All that I am, and I'm a better man since you taught me by sharing your life. You are the sun.
What do you like to read?
Peter Pan. I like to read Snow White.
I love my children very much and proud to be their dad.